Coming up on today's Boston Celtics Today, we're going to take a look at the top 15 remaining NBA free agents who the Celtics can still sign. We also have a new Grant Williams update. But first, make sure you subscribe to us here on Boston Celtics Today for year-round coverage on the seas. We are 400 people away from another massive milestone here on the channel of 19,000 subs. So lock us in, subscribe, and anytime the Celtics make a move throughout this free agency period, we'll cover it here on the show. As always, welcome into NBA Now by Chat Sports. I'm Chase Senior. Appreciate all of you for being here with us on this fine Saturday. Hope all of you out there are having a fantastic weekend. Let's begin here with a Grant Williams update. He is a restricted free agent and one of the top remaining free agents who we will discuss on today's show. A couple of teams interested in Grant Williams here, restricted free agent. So obviously the Boston Celtics, if he lands a contract offer elsewhere, going to have an opportunity here to match that offer if they want to bring him back. But Boston has not shown interest in bringing him back. Obviously, Boston able to fortify that front court with that Kristaps Porzingis trade. One of the moves that Boston made on day one, a two-year contract extension with Porzingis. So he opted in to the final year of his deal. So basically 2 years on top of that, 1 year. So basically a three-year extension for Kristaps Porzingis to remain with the Boston Celtics. The Dallas Mavericks said to be interested in Grant Williams as well. Everybody wants to rip him for the Eastern Conference Finals series against the Miami Heat when he got in the face of Jimmy Butler. I actually give him credit for showing some dog and being fearless against Jimmy Butler after he was giving the Boston Celtics that work. Nobody else on the Celtics wanted to guard Jimmy Butler. Grant Williams rose up and he at least tried. And he is a big in today's NBA who can guard multiple positions and shoot the three-point shot as well. So I think he'd be a good fit for the Dallas Mavericks. I'm actually somewhat surprised that the Celtics might not bring him back. He just might be out of their price range. Without further ado, let's take a look at the top 15 remaining free agents here. Let's start with Brook Lopez. What a job he has done extending his NBA career and evolving to the point where he's a pretty good three-point shooter at this point of his career, and he's a really good defensive player as well, one of the top defensive centers in the NBA. So, good rim protector, a guy who can stretch the floor. Some chatter about the Houston Rockets giving him about $20 million per year. If Jakob Poeltl and Nikola Vucevic can get $20 million average annual value, Brook Lopez might be in that neighborhood. There's also a lot of traction behind D'Angelo Russell going back to the Los Angeles Lakers. Shout out to Rob Pelinka. I think he's done a really, really good job since the NBA trade deadline. All he had to do was trade away Russell Westbrook to make that roster make a lot more sense. They bring in Rui Hachimura for the corpse that is Kendrick Nunn. They make a couple of other moves, and they brought in D'Angelo Russell as well. In the NBA playoffs, D'Lo was not good, but even though the Lakers did sign Gabe Vincent to that three-year deal, making about $11 million per season, their backcourt could be Gabe Vincent, solid defender, and D'Lo, who's not an awful player, averaged a tick under 18 points per game last year. Rob Pelinka, shout out to you. Jackson Hayes bringing in Cam Reddish, a couple of other moves so far in NBA free agency. That's why you subscribe to our Lakers channel and tune into us here on Chat Sports, because we've been talking about all of the moves in total that the Lakers and all 30 teams across the NBA have made. With that, let's ask you this question. This will be our pinned comment as well, so make sure you drop a name down below in the comment section. Who is the best free agent left? Let us know right now. Let's continue to look forward at this list. Austin Reaves, a player who there was some talk about him getting about $20 million per year. Then I saw a report that he was maybe going to get about $15 million per year. Very good showing in the NBA playoffs for the Western Conference Finals-bound Los Angeles Lakers. His regular season numbers, 13 points per game. His postseason numbers, even better than that. Solid and willing defender and a growing offensive player. I think he's going to go back to the Lakers as well. Dante DiVincenzo. Last year with Golden State, he signed a two-year deal with the player option on that back half. He did not take and accept that player option because it was less than $5 million. I think DiVincenzo could go to a team like the New York Knicks and cash in between $8 to $10 million per. Good athlete, still young. I still think there's a better basketball player in there than what he's shown. He can handle, he can defend. Very good athlete for Golden State last year. 9.5 points per shot, around 40% from downtown. Grant Williams, the player who we talked about at the start of the show, kind of shared my feelings on Grant Williams, but we can look at his numbers here with what Williams did a year ago for Boston, and a player who I like him just because of the toughness, has that baseline jumper, has that corner three. If you remember 2 years ago against the Milwaukee Bucks in that game seven at TD Garden, my man knocked down 7 3-pointers. So not afraid of the big moment. 8 points, 4.5 rebounds. He goes to a team where he has a larger role. He could be about a 10-point-per-game guy. PJ Washington also still available here on day two of NBA free agency. I like his versatility as well. A lot of players who have played a lot for the Charlotte Hornets, people don't really understand the value that they have just because the Hornets are always a dumpster fire. 16 points per game, not a great rebounder for his size at 6'7", 230, but he's been putting up some numbers for a really long time. The Lakers reportedly interested in Eric Gordon, one of the top destinations for him. He's been in the league for 15 years. If you're looking for a solid defender at that guard spot and a guy who 2 years ago shot more than 40% from three-point range, that's a player who is appealing for a lot of playoff-level championship-contending teams. Maybe you can get him on a mid-level exception or something in that neighborhood. Christian Wood, a big who can stretch the floor. Last year, 16.5 points per game, 7 rebounds. He can at least handle a little bit and get that offense going on the offensive end of the floor. I think that he brings you value just because of the fact that he can knock down those threes, has a sweet jumper, nice touch from about 15 feet and in. There is always value for a big who can knock down the triple. NBA free agency, live day two. A lot of good remaining free agents left there on this free agency pool. I will be live for several hours here on Saturday, as well as the entire Chat Sports crew helping me behind the scenes, and we'll be bringing on some personalities here as well. Whenever a signing happens, we'll be talking about it. Day two, July underway. Signing's going to be coming in hot. Dylan Brooks, Houston Rockets, seemed like a very obvious destination here. With his antics, how he's carried himself, and the fact that his three-point game has kind of flatlined a little bit, his value has gone down if you look at the talk on social media. But I do think there are teams out there, even though he criticized LeBron James, and then LeBron James just dominated him in the first round of the playoffs, like willing defender, very solid defender, and if he can be a better three-point shooter, like he's shown at moments in his NBA career, a lot of value too for a team that's either trying to get over the hump in playoff contention or maybe compete for a championship. Glue guy, for sure. Russell Westbrook. Credit to him, and I've never really been a big Russell Westbrook guy. I love his intensity. I love how hard he plays. I hate that he doesn't have a good feel for the game and never can slow the motor down in the guts of the game where sometimes you need to have a better feel. He lacks that. Doesn't have touch. Can't shoot the three-point shot. With the Los Angeles Clippers, though, Ty Lue put him in a spot to be successful, and I thought he was really successful for Los Angeles. If the Clippers don't trade for James Harden, Russ could be an ideal point guard for LA next year. Kelly Oubre Jr. put up big numbers for the Charlotte Hornets, but he's not a guy on a quality team. He's going to give you 20 points per game every single night when he's been on a good team, which is rare in his NBA career. Golden State Warriors, he kind of struggled to fit into that lineup. I would say he's an average defender. I wish that he had more awareness and put forward a little bit more effort, but I think Kelly Oubre at this point, a good stats, bad team player. I'm interested to see where he ends up. We know that a lot of people love Kelly Oubre just because of the name value there. Mason Plumlee, this is interesting here because Zubats is said to be on the trade block for the Los Angeles Clippers with some talk about Plumlee stepping in as the starting center. He's capable on a team like the Clippers if they currently stay as constituted with the Paul George, a Kawhi Leonard, low-maintenance big who doesn't need to stretch the floor. He gets dirty on that low block. If he goes back to the Los Angeles Clippers and he starts and Zubats does get traded, it helps LA save a little bit of money. Obviously, they're cash-strapped. Malik Beasley, intriguing option here as a guy who can come in off the bench as a 7-8 man, nearly 13 points per game a year ago. The lack of efficiency from the field is a little bit of a problem. Sub 40% from the deck last year. Couple more players left here. Mo Bamba let go by the Los Angeles Lakers. He was a trade deadline acquisition for the Lake Show. Just hasn't put it together throughout his NBA career. When you have a song about you, that increases your name value. But when you're not that good of a player, you kind of struggle to find a home at the NBA level. Jay Crowder was not in the playoff rotation for the Milwaukee Bucks, but he rounds out our list of the top 15 free agents left here across the NBA. 3-and-D player, has played in a lot of high-leverage playoff games, in the pressure cooker, never really scared of the moment, doesn't get too timid. He might be cooked, but he can give you 10 to 15 minutes per night for a playoff team. With that, let's ask you this. Shout out your favorite team down in the comment section right now. And do not forget to join us for day two of NBA Free Agency. We were live for several hours for day one. Going to be hanging out for day two. And we'll be live for the next few days of NBA Free Agency as well.